Welcome to the second module on modeling of multi-machine 9-bus system using MATLAB Simulink. In today's session, we are mainly going to cover the following points. Firstly, we will see a 3-machine 9-bus system and then various parameter calculation of the transmission line with the transmission line length and resistance, inductance and capacitance. Now, this is the 3-machine 9-bus system which we are going to study. As you can see from here, it has got three generators, generator 1, generator 2 and generator 3. There are total of 9 transmission lines. There are 3 loads, load A, load B and load C, and 3 power transformers. Now, before working on the 3-machine 9-bus system, the first thing which we must know is how to calculate the various transmission line parameters. Now, what are the various parameters which we must consider? The first thing is how to calculate the transmission line length. Now, what do we require in order to calculate the transmission line length? If you see the data sheet of a transmission line, then you will see this kind of thing in which you are given the value of resistance, inductive reactance and susceptance. However, all these values are given in per unit value. But for our MATLAB modeling, we need to calculate the actual values of the resistance, inductance and capacitance from these per unit values. Now, so let us now see how to calculate these various parameters. In order to calculate the length of the transmission line, the following formula has been applied. Length is given by square root of inductive reactance multiplied by the susceptance divided by 2 pi f, where f is the frequency, and this is then multiplied with the velocity of the light in kilometers per second. For all our further calculations, we are considering the frequency as 60 hertz. Now, as I said that there are total of 9 transmission lines, and for our example, we will consider the transmission line which connects the buses 4 and 5. As you can see from this table, the value of resistance in per unit has been given as 0.010. The value of inductive reactance has been given as 0.085. And the value of susceptance has been given as 0.176. All these values are in the per unit values. Firstly, in order to find out the value of transmission length, we have to consider the various values. Now, the base values of voltage and power, they are taken as 230 kV is the value of the base voltage and 100 MVA is the value of the base power which we'll be using for all our further calculations. And we are since considering the line which is connecting the bus number 4 and 5, these values of resistance, inductive reactance and susceptance have been taken from the table shown you earlier. Now, as I said, the length is calculated by square root of x multiplied by b divided by 2 pi f into velocity of the light. All these values, when we put the line length, we calculate as 97.33 kilometers. Now, by using the same formula, we can calculate the transmission line length of the different buses also. Now, after calculating the value of the line length, the next thing which we have to consider is how to calculate the various parameters. The first parameter which we will calculate is the resistance. Now, when we talk of the resistance, we need to find the value of R actual. R actual is given as the base value of resistance multiplied by the per unit value of resistance. The per unit value of resistance we have already seen from the table earlier. The base value is given as square of the base voltage divided by the active power base value. Now, after putting these two values, in the previous table we have seen the values as 230 kV and 100 MVA. We find out the value of the base value of resistance as 529 ohms. Now, from this base value of the resistance, we find out the actual value by calculating this base value with the per unit value. So, R actual is calculated as 529 multiplied by 0.01 and finally we get it as 5.29 ohms. However, we need to find out the value of resistance in per kilometer. The value of the transmission length line we have already calculated as 97.33 kilometers. So, the value of resistance in ohms per kilometer is calculated as 5.29 divided by 97.33 ohms per kilometer. So this is basically the positive sequence resistance, and similarly we can find out the value of zero sequence resistance by multiplying this value of R1 with 3. So finally we get the value of R1 as 0.0543 ohms per kilometer, and the value of zero sequence resistance is calculated by multiplying it by 3, and finally we get the value 0.163 ohms per kilometer. So this is how we calculate the value of resistance. In a similar manner, we can calculate the value of positive sequence and zero sequence inductance. Now the value of X base is the same as that of the R base, which we calculated earlier. So X base was the same as R base, which we calculated as 529. So this value we take as such. Now X actual is calculated by multiplying the value of the base reactance, inductive reactance, with the per unit value. The per unit value is calculated from the table which I had already showed you. So this is how we calculate the value of X actual as 44.965 ohms. From this value we can find out the value of L actual. How is this L actual calculated? This is calculated from this formula. L actual means actual value of inductance is calculated by dividing the actual value of inductive reactance with 2 pi f. And the frequency, as I already told you, for all our further calculations, we are considering as 60 Hertz. So when we put the value of 2 pi and 60 as this and find out the value of L actual, it comes out to be 0.1192 Henry's. In a similar manner, we have to find out the value of inductance in per kilometers. So that is where we calculate the value of L Henry per kilometer by dividing this with the length of the transmission line. And finally, we get the value as 1.225 into 10 raised to the minus 3 Henry's per kilometer. Now this is the positive sequence inductance, and similarly we can find out the value of zero sequence inductance by multiplying this with 3, and finally we get the value of L1 as 1.22 e raised to the minus 3 Henry's per kilometer. Similarly, the zero sequence inductance is calculated as 3.676 e raised to the minus 3 Henry's in per kilometer. In a similar manner, we will find out the value of capacitance. Now, in order to find out the value of capacitance, we have to take the value of susceptance from the data sheet. The per unit value is already known to us from the data sheet, and the base value of susceptance we find out by using the formula SB, that is active power base value, divided by the square of the voltage, that is base value. And the values are 100 and 230. So when we put these values here, we find out the value of base susceptance as 1.890 multiplied by 10 raised to the minus 3. This base value of the susceptance now will be used in order to find out the actual value of susceptance by multiplying the base value of susceptance with the per unit value. So when we multiply this with the per unit value, we get the value of the susceptance as 3.3264 multiplied by 10 raised to the minus 4. Now from this value, we find out the value of C actual, that is the actual value of capacitance, by dividing it by 2 pi f. So that is how we get the value of capacitance as 8.8235 into 10 raised to the minus 7 farads. However, finally we want the value in per kilometers. So we divide it with the transmission line length, that is 97.33, and finally the value of C1 is calculated as 9.065 into 10 raised to the minus 9 farads per kilometer. And we find the value of zero sequence capacitance by multiplying this with 3, and that is calculated as 2.719 into 10 raised to the minus 8 farads per kilometer. Now for our example, we had taken only one transmission line, that is 4 and 5. In a similar manner, we can find out the values of the different transmission line parameters such as positive sequence resistance, zero sequence resistance, positive sequence inductance, zero sequence inductance, positive sequence capacitance, zero sequence capacitance, as well as the transmission line length of the different buses. And finally, we arrive at this. Now these values will be further used for the modeling of the 3-machine 9-bus system. So in our today's session, we have seen how to calculate the transmission line length, how to calculate the various other parameters such as resistance, inductance and capacitance. And what do we have? We have basically the base values of resistance, inductive reactance, as well as susceptance. All these values are in the per unit value. Also, we need to find out base values of the voltage as well as the base values of the power. So, this is how we calculate the transmission line parameters.